Same. I think how much of it is first covered? Like, I'm not aware. Whether I told about sourcing, working substance, heat engine, and all. I guess I remember, I do remember that I have covered the limitations in the first lab. Right?
Yes, sir.
Whether, what about this thermal reservoir source, substance, sink, heat engine? Whether it was covered?
Till source it was covered, sir.
We shall recap once again the mission. Okay, shall we start? Okay, so in the last class, we have discussed about the limitations of the first lab and why there was a need for the emerging of a second lab when there was a first lab. So, first lab accounts for the major aspects, but the energy interaction is not adhered very well. So, in that sense, we have discussed the various limitations through which the first lab is being limited to apply, and there comes the essentiality for a new law to emerge, which is the second law of thermodynamics. In the second law, we have to discuss some of the important definitions in order to, before you go for a direct statement, that is the statement of laws of second laws of thermodynamics. Before that, you have to understand some sort of definitions, which forms the preliminary concepts, which you must understand in order to understand the statement of the law. So, in that particular sense, we'll discuss some of the statements here, some of the definitions here. So, the first one being the thermal reservoir. So, thermal reservoir can be anything. It is a substance or a system which has an infinite capacity of storage of thermal energy. But the condition is how much heat you provide to the system. How much heat you provide to a system. The temperature of that particular system remains constant, in vice versa also, in the sense how much heat if you take away from the system also, it does not affect the temperature of the system. So such a system, such a substance is known as a thermal reservoir. So thermal reservoir, you can just think as a bath, you can think as a sink, you can think as one whole sort of material, just as a matchbox, you can think. Okay, it is that particular thing where it can gain infinite amount of energy and can give out infinite amount of heat without changing its temperature. So this thermal reservoir is being categorized into two different things, the one being the source and other being the sink. Even the subsequent definitions will explain you about the same thing. So, source is something which has infinite heat giving capacity. That means it can give out heat how much it is required for you without affecting its temperature. In the same sense, sink is a thermal reservoir where it can accept any sort of heat, okay, any sort of heat which is dumped into it but without changing its temperature. So, these are some of the definitions of preliminary concepts, that is thermal reservoir, source, and sink. Now coming to the working substance. So working substance can be anything. It could be air, it could be water, it could be anything which drives the overall system. So, Nishchat, can you just read the content given for working substance here? Is it legible over there? Nishchat?
It must be some substance through which the heat is absorbed or rejected into the sink This is the working substance.
This is the working substance, he says. It must be some substance, some sort of material where it can extract the heat from the source and give it out to the sink. There must be some intervening medium, which is known as a working substance, according to the description given in this definition. Let us understand what is this about. Okay, if you could look at it, this is a typical heat engine diagram. So this is a typical heat engine diagram. How a heat engine works, you need to understand it very carefully. Okay. Now let us think and assume this particular thing as a heat engine. So in order to work on this engine, there must be two thermal reservoirs. Okay, there must be two thermal reservoirs. One being the source and other being the sink. As we have just came across, the source is a thermal reservoir where it can give you any amount of heat without changing its temperature. So let me take the source is giving K1 amount of heat to the heat engine. Okay, so source is providing how much? Q1 amount of heat for the heat engine. So heat engine, what does it does? It utilizes Q1 amount of heat and rejects Q2 amount of heat to the sink. So Q1 amount of heat is being extracted from the source and Q2 amount of heat is being rejected into the sink. The difference between these two values, that is Q1 minus Q2, okay, will account for the work done by the heat engine. Okay, so if it has grabbed 100 kilowatt of heat energy from the source and it has rejected 20 kilowatts of heat energy to the sink, then what will be my net work output from the heat engine, which is given as Q1 minus Q2?
80.
So it would be 80 kilowatts of power, which will be continuously generating from the heat engine. So this is a typical example where you understand how an heat engine works. So it works between two reservoirs. What are those?
Source and sink.
It is a source and a sink. Source is a thermal reservoir which has infinite heat giving capacity, and sink is a thermal reservoir where it can take infinite amount of heat into it. Okay, so this all I explained just to understand the meaning of working substance here. So there has to be some medium that takes the heat from the source like this and give it to the heat engine. Okay, and then it transfers the remaining heat into the sink like this. Correct. There has to be some medium, some source, through which the heat will get transferred from source to the sink through the heat engine working. So this particular substance which transfers the heat is known as the working substance. It could be anything. So working substance could be your air, could be your water. Any medium can exist there. So we will come across all this while you are going deep into the second law of thermodynamics. As of now, any doubts, guys? Till now?
No, sir. Okay.
So, Muhammad Amin, can you just explain us what do you mean by a source? So, can you just say what do you mean by source?
Source is a system which provides heat to the.
Okay, it provides the heat. So, subject to the constraint, there is a condition and a characteristic of the source. What is that?
The heat of source cannot be changed due to temperature is high.
Sorry, I did not get you on me. With? And with Sirai. Others? Okay.
Sir, Anvit present, sir.
Yes, ma'am. I did not call you for the attendance, but in the sense I asked you the definition of source. So not listening the class, Anvit, right?
Sir, I just went out to drink water.
So, how much time does it take to drink water, man? Even I drank it a couple of times during the class itself. Please do listen, guys. When there is a new module or a new concept which is taught at an initial stage, which forms a very important aspect of the whole module. Why? Because if you understand these concepts, the whole other part of the module will go out very smoothly and it will be very interesting. But if you do not understand the basic things, the construction of an heat engine, all this, if you see the entire second law of thermodynamics, the only thing which you come across is this. Only thing which you come across is this. So all the problems, okay, all the theoretical concepts will be having this sort of diagrams. All the thing will be having this sort of diagrams. So if you understand this pretty well, then whatever might be the concepts in the future, will understand it and even you gain the interest on the topic. So that is why whenever, not only the second law of thermodynamics, whenever there is a new concept started in a new class, so the first two classes plays a very, very important role. Why? Because in those two classes itself, I'll be explaining what are the core concepts of the whole module, is it? So that's why, please, please pay attention. Okay, Shravan Pujari. Shravan. Shravan Pujari. Doctor. Rakshan. Rakshan. Women, is there any problem with your mic? Okay. Next is Prarthan Jain. Prarthan. So even you have a mic problem. Sriraj.
Yes, sir.
So, what do you mean by source, man? Okay, guys. So this is the last warning, guys. I want everyone to listen what I say. So even I can cut short the things for 15 minutes earlier and do so, but I want everyone to just listen what I say. Okay? Why? Because this forms are very important in order to learn the concepts. I'm using the laptop, so microphone is not working. Okay, fine. Okay. So from the next class, I want everyone to be interactive with me and answering all the questions in between. Okay, so that syllabus will move away very fast. Is that clear? Will that commitment will be given by you in the next class? Yes or no?
Yes,
sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. Yes, sir.
So if you feel bored in any way in the middle of the class, you can just stop me. You can wait for some time and then we can start, or else you can do it in the next class also. That doesn't even matter. But I want whatever I would explain, I want it to be beneficial. So from the next class, everyone be interactive and we shall enjoy the concepts. Abdul Rahiman.
Yes, sir.
Is that enough?
Yes, sir.
Reservoir that supplies energy in the form of heat is source. Okay, that's right. But subject to the constraint that it can give away any amount of heat, but the temperature of that particular source should not change. So that is the condition. Okay. Ashan and Mustafa is not there. Okay. Ahmad Reza.
Yes, sir.
Fayar Kotian. Amit S. Lahari. Amrit. Anvit C. Rai.
Yes, sir.
Ashwin.
Present, sir.
Present, sir.
Shreya Kotian. Okay. Ashwin K. is there? Okay, he's there.
Present, sir.
Guys, if you can just put me a message in that box. Like, see, if I call Ashwin, next is Ashwita. If Ashwita knows that she is next to Ashwin, he can just put a message straight away. Okay? So that I need not call your name.
Sir, Adarsh, you didn't call my name.
Adarsh, yes, okay, done. Done, Adarsh. Next is Ashwita. Yeah, done. Next, Chandan. If you know the order, you can, if you're preceding person, hope you know the order, right? I mean, according to the USL. So if you know it, if you're preceding person, just answers the attendance. So you can immediately put a message in the chat box. If you observe that your preceding person has already put a message in the chat box, then you can even straight away put the message. Okay, I can just take the attendance from that itself. Chandan C. This was a Binoy. Fahad. Faisal. Gaurav. Gautam Hedges. Okay, Gautam Hedges is there. Chandel is there. Parav is there. Next. M. Karthik. M. Karthik. See, okay. Let's see. Muhammad Faseel. Okay. Sihab. Muhammad Sihab. Muhammad Tawsif Ali. Muwas. Okay. N. Suraj. Next is Nafa. Namita. Next is Nartan. Nish. Okay. Nartan. Niharika. Okay. Nishchat is Yatin George. Yes. Omkar. Prathan Jain. Satish. Swarna. Prajat. Prajat. Akshan K. Andas. Prajat Rai. Prajat. Andas. Ranjit. Shabat. Okay, done. Sagar Sacharya. Okay. Shazad Abdullah. Shashank BC. Shetty Sujay. Shashank is there. Okay. Shetty Sujay is there. Shetty Tejas. Okay, not there. Shravan Pujari is there. Sriraj. Saurabha. Sumant. Varun. Sumant is there, okay. Amit Sangoli. Lesh Merkel. Yes, is there. Nagash Merkel, Pachwal Hegde. Sandesh Shankar. Pachwal Hegde is there, okay. Vachan. Editing. Which Rachan, okay, Rohan is there, Varun, Adarsh is there, Muhammad Amin, Numan Asadi. Okay, guys, so I do expect from the next class that you'll be interactive with me and make the class beautiful. Till then, take care, have a nice day. Okay.
Chandra
present. Chandra. Okay, Chandra.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
ಕಿಚಡಿ ಏನಾದರೂ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರಾ?